Hey guys, welcome back to our new video. So this is basically a continuation to our previously made video. So previously we discussed about numbers, or you can say integers, in Python. So we'll be continuing forward. Today I'll be explaining about some of the building functions that we can use with the integer data type, and also we'll be discussing about the what do you say about casting. How can we type cast cast a data type? So let's begin. Suppose I have a variable called random with number equals to 23, and now I have a random, let's say, decimal equals to, so as you can see I have declared a random number and then a random decimal. So this is of type integer and this is of type float. If I want to cast a float into an integer, what do I have to do? The result is pretty simple. If I write here, first let me show you guys that the type is float. So the type is float, right? Now I am going to change it into integer. So what I have to do is just wait. So here you can see that what I have done is I have casted the random decimal which was in float to integer by using the int method. Now this is a built-in function, guys, so you don't have to import any library, you just can use it straightforward. Okay, so you can just use it right away, there will be no problem. So in the same way I can cast the integer which I have declared here into decimal. So the process is similar. I'll be writing here random number equals to float, and then again. Okay, so now if I print here the type, the type of, here you can see I'll get float. So the integer has been converted into float. Okay, this can come very handy, guys, so just clarify these things, right? Okay, let me take another cell and write some basic Python built-in functions that we can use in our day-to-day life. The most common one is abs, absolute value, sorry, which is the absolute value. Now if I write here 3.45, it will return the absolute value of 3.45, which is 3.45. Just wait a second, guys. I think I've done a mistake here. Let's see. Wait. Just wait. Let's declare a number. And if I write here ABS. Wait, just let me check. Okay, I think the syntax is correct. So this function, the ABS function, will return the absolute value of a number that we pass. So let me take a negative integer, otherwise you can't just get through it. So let us take number equals to minus 90, and then if I write here, okay, you can see here it will be minus 90. Okay, the same way we can use another function called round. If I write here, if I pass an argument like 23.45, which is a decimal number, and then if I specify to round up to one decimal point, you can see this will return 23.4. okay, the same way if I write here 23.45 up to two decimal point, it will come as 23.45. okay, so that's how it works, guys. Let's give you another example. Here you can see 23.46. so that's exactly how round works, the round function works in Python. We also have another function called power. So if I write here 3 to the power 2, we all know 3 to the power 2 is 9. So that's how we can use various mathematical function for carrying out operations in Python, different arithmetic operations in Python. So I think we are pretty clear here that we can use a lot of these all are built-in functions, so we can use them all for carrying out arithmetic operations in Python. So there are a lot of functions. I don't recall some of them. One more thing, hexadecimal number, yes, that is important. If I write here, suppose I write here a equals to 90. Now I don't know, want to know the hexadecimal of a, I'll just write here hex. I guess that will work. Let's see. Yeah, it is working. So we are getting the hexadecimal number of a, which is 90. So this is it. And there are still a lot of functions which are left. Just googling, just wait. Okay, you can see here there are lots and lots of functions. You can go through it. They are pretty simple. There is nothing to worry about. They are basic stuff. Okay, if I try to cover each and every function, it will be very late. So I'll just try to cut this off. Okay, so you can see here there are a ton of functions which you can use, which will come across, which we are going to use in some point of time in our lectures. So this is the thing. All right, I hope we are clear here. So see you tomorrow, guys. Bye. Good night.